Hello and welcome on my first vlog ever, guys. So the first thing first is that I want to ask you guys, if you notice some vlog mistakes in my video, please comment in the section below so I'll make sure that I read them and improve my vlog in the future. So today's vlog is gonna be about my daily routine on the Saturday and the Sunday, what am I actually doing in these days, and yeah, that's all. So I hope you enjoy it, and good luck.
After a luxurious 15 hours sleep, I found myself disoriented about the time, so I reached for my smartphone to check. Next thing I know, I was lounging on my bed, captivated by TikTok videos for a good 3 hours. It's amazing how the time flies when you are entertained. Eventually, I turned myself away from the screen and dived into a game of Counter-Strike. While the game offers plenty of excitement, it does give you some downsides. Some players can be quite aggressive, using language that's offensive and harmful, and cyberbullying some individuals. It's sad to see cyberbullying being so common, especially in games like Counter-Strike 2, which leads to depression, anxiety, and the fear of society for some people. Personally, I try to be a good example of digital citizen by following the rules of digital law, where everyone is responsible for their actions and words. I try to be a positive influence online and avoid any bullying behavior. After a couple of hours of gaming, I switched over to YouTube and to unwind and relax after the intensity of talk. YouTube is so relaxing and—
Whoa! Pause on that!
Stop it! Is that the real life?
Is this what we consider a healthy lifestyle? Personally, I don't see this as a healthy living, not even close. So right now, I will show you guys what in my opinion is a real healthy lifestyle, and what is digital well-being. Firstly, I start my day by drinking water. Drinking water is crucial for maintaining hydration, supporting bodily functions, regulating temperature, flushing out toxins, and promoting overall health and well-being. So the first things first is that I start the day of the warm-up from the warm-up, and morning warm-up sets the tone for the day, priming both body and the mind for the optimal performance. Heat jumpstarts circulation, delivering oxygen and nutrients to muscles and organs while flushing out toxins. This prepares muscles and joints for the day's physical demands, reducing the risk of injury. Additionally, a warm-up stimulates the nervous system, enhancing coordination and reaction times. Mentally, it sharpens focus and concentration, promoting productivity and efficiency throughout the day. Moreover, a morning warm-up boosts mood and energy levels, fostering a positive outlook and motivation to tackle challenges. In essence, it lays the foundation for a successful and fulfilling day ahead. By the way, as you can see, I'm doing push-ups. According to the Malone 2023, the average number of push-ups for 14 years old is 25. And my personal best was 40, but that was a year ago, so never mind. So for right now, I'm doing pull-ups, and the pull-ups strengthen the upper body muscles, improve grip strength, and enhance overall fitness and functional strength. After that, I usually start to meditate and stretch, and that is one of the best parts of my day. It's so relaxing and it's so satisfying. Beginning the day with meditation and stretching confers numerous benefits. Meditation cultivates mental clarity, reduces stress, and enhances emotional well-being, setting a positive tone for the day. It promotes mindfulness, enabling individuals to focus on the present moment and approach tasks with a heightened awareness and calmness. Additionally, stretching increases flexibility, improves circulation, and alleviates the muscle tension, preparing the body for physical activities and reducing the risk of injury. Together, these practices promote holistic wellness, fostering a sense of balance, resilience, and the vitality that permeates throughout the day, enabling individuals to navigate challenges with grace and equanimity. By the way, the TV is very important for me in the digital health, as it provides access to guided meditation apps, calming music, and the instructional videos for yoga and stretching routines as in the video. These resources enhance relaxation and the mindfulness, making it easier to incorporate these practices into daily routines for the improved mental and physical well-being.
See, right now my pulse is equal to 89 sometimes. It's just that I'm relaxing right now, as you might see, and but as you can see, it was 106, like right now, yeah, 106. It was when I was warming up right there, and also when I was doing pull-ups right there and the push-ups right here. So always make sure that you're checking your pulse with the help of your gadgets, like the smartphones, or maybe even like Apple Watch or just Garmin watches. Always make sure that you are checking your pulse.
After taking a shower and drying off, I put on my warm clothes and went playing basketball outside. Playing basketball outdoors in the breathing fresh air for 30 minutes is vital for physical and mental health. Outdoor activity boosts vitamin D levels, strengthens the immune system and enhances mood. Breathing fresh air improves lung function, reduces stress and increases oxygen supply to the brain, promoting overall well-being and cognitive function. And maybe even if it's cold out, I still enjoy playing basketball, so I'll play it any time of the year. After my alarm on my smartphone for 30 minutes would turn on, I went back home. Right after, I started preparing for my summative assessment for the next week and doing my homework. I also rest after every 30 minutes of work. Resting after 30 minutes of computer work is crucial for maintaining productivity and preventing physical strain. Continuous screen exposure can lead to eye strain, head injuries, and reduced cognitive function. Taking short breaks allows the eyes to relax, prevents muscle stiffness, and refreshes the mind, enhancing focus and efficiency. Incorporating regular test intervals can significantly improve overall well-being and work performance, making it an essential practice for anyone engaged in computer-based tasks.
So in conclusion, guys, I can say that I'm a very good example of the digital citizen and the digital well-being, because in today's vlog I just showed you guys how the different gadgets that I use help me to have a healthy lifestyle. For example, how the smartphones, how the different gadgets like the TVs and the watches help me to have a healthy lifestyle. And maybe even though I'm playing computer games often, but I'm still trying my best to remove myself from the computer games. And also I didn't hurt anyone in this video, and I didn't hurt even the environment in this video. So I think that I'm a good example of the digital citizen, and in overall I'm just not hurting everyone, so please don't get me wrong. So I hope you liked it. Thank you so much. Goodbye, see you next time.